Quick look at the markets now. Tom Piotrowski over at CommSec. How are we shaping up today, Tom?
Well, Pete, the futures optimistically are telling us the ASX 200 will be up by a third of a percent when we kick off, but you take that with a pinch of salt, given the hurdles that we have to navigate in the coming day. We've got quarterly inflation numbers to look at. We'll have an update from Rio Tinto in terms of earnings. The Northern Hemisphere trend was one tending towards the downside, particularly where technology names have been concerned. And we're moving into a window of time where there are quite a few risk events, if you like, Pete. We've got central bank decisions. We've got important earnings to look at as well. And so to that end, the NASDAQ was down by 1.3%, reflecting that weakness where technology names are concerned. The S&P 500 down by 0.5%, and the Dow was up by 0.5%. Just highlighting that point around the technology space and earnings. Microsoft has reported its figures for the last quarter just moments ago. And in broad terms, these figures were in line with the market's expectations, Pete, but the shares fell away by as much as 8% in after-hours trade. So that was largely on an in-line number. There'll be some features of that figure that get teased out. There was a slightly bigger spend in terms of what Microsoft invested over the course of the last quarter, and a big portion of that obviously is trying to get that growth dividend out of artificial intelligence. And just to put that into perspective, they spent $13.8 billion on investing in their own business over the course of the last quarter. That number was a little bit richer than what the market was looking at, and that perhaps may have been a factor in pushing the share price lower. The Aussie dollar reflecting the weakness in commodity prices overnight, and that's a theme that we're quite familiar with, so it's currently trading around 65.3 US cents.
Okay, Tom Piotrowski, thank you.